It is now my pleasure to introduce the artist Shimabuku, who is someone who we had quite early on our minds when we talked about extinction and plan for the Extinction Marathon, because his work is very much about traditions and, you know, a combination of natural world, exploring the natural world and human culture through installations, through videos, his drawing works, sculptures, and mainly also performances. Shimabuku again urges the viewers to reform our ways of how we perceive and respond to the world around us. And recent solo exhibitions include Flying Me at the Kunsthalle Bern this year, Something That Floats, Something That Sinks at the Icon Gallery in Birmingham in 2013, and Noto and the 21st Century Museum of Contemporary Art in Kanazawa in Japan in 2013. Shimabuku has also participated in 2014 in the Taipei Biennial, which under the title The Great Acceleration, Art in the Anthropocene. Today, Shimabuku will be presenting a talk titled Can You Clean a Fish? Please welcome with me Shimabuku.
Hello. Yeah, thank you for having me here. It's very nice to see so many people for Sunday lunchtime. When I heard about this project's Extinction Marathon, I thought it's nice to show what I did recently. So I'm going to show you some images that I'm going to talk over. This is an exhibition I did in France, CAPC Bordeaux. It was a small solo show that I made. Three, four works, but the one work was called Can You Clean a Fish? So it was a video, 10 video installation about, how you can clean a fish, 10 different kinds of fish. No, for me, it was like, some sort of, statement or message, because a kind of metaphor, because, you use a computer, a laptop computer, but you don't know, where it is made or who made it. We are, kind of lacking this, we don't know what's going on, in between. And I eat a fish, but I didn't really know how to clean a fish, So it's kind of metaphor, I should know something beautiful or interesting happening in the between, from beginning to the end. So I made this work. But after that, I had an invitation from a 21st Century Museum, Kanazawa, Japan. That is, architecture is a sana. It's very nice. It's nice glass building, you probably know. So they invited me to the kind of 1 year project. Then they said, it's kind of an ongoing project. Then we make a two opening at the beginning and the middle. Then also another condition is that they asked me to work with the local young people. Then they said they have money to do it. So what I decided to do is I decided to go to the place called Noto. Noto is about like 2 hours up from car from Kanazawa. It's kind of like a center north, let's say. It's kind of peninsula. It's a very remote place because there's no train. And I mean, they still have a very unique culture or tradition. So this purple underneath is it's Kanazawa, where there is a museum. And then red part, this peninsula is Noto. So I decided to go there together with young people. First thing I found is this glass house, which, this is actually dried persimmon. So this is, you know, you have like a dried date and things like that. So it's some similar things. So it's very tradition to have a dried persimmon, but not in such a beautiful color. So people in Noto make you know, dried persimmon in such a beautiful color. So I was quite amazed about it. So I wanted to learn about it together with young people. To me, what is interesting thing was, you know, traditional thing is kind of updating or made in a kind of modern way. So this is the reason why they need to make such kind of a glass pavilion to, you know, why they can keep such a beautiful color is that they are controlling the moisture of air. So my first idea was this is, this, you know, building is very similar to Sanna building. So I thought it's nice to have make a, you know, dried persimmon in a museum. So we went to learn how to make it from beginning to the end, you know. And so first we, you know, peel out the skin. And there is a special machine to cut only a top part of the skin like this. Then it's easier to peel out. Then we brought back 500 persimmon to the museum. This is a museum workshop. Yeah, for me, like why I'm doing this with the young people is because, you know, young people, maybe they don't know how to make omelets, but they know how to make, you know, such a special, you know, dried, you know, persimmon. That, you know, that's, I call it my own public art, you know, we make a special people. Yeah, actually, for the, I negotiated with museum people, but they couldn't have a persimmon inside a museum because of, you know, they worry about the insect and things like that. So we have to have a small, you know, small container like this. Yeah, we just installed just outside of the museum. So like this, I tried to make a traditional thing with the young people, kind of, you know, try to make a seasonal thing. Yeah, it was like a natural color is really beautiful. So I wanted to compare with you know, kind of artificial color on the artwork in the museum. In winter, we went back again. Then we found kind of dried fish making. Actually, this is familiar here in Europe or England too. It's a dried cod and a dried anchovy, things like that. So yeah, we wanted to study this because we didn't know what kind, what is a kind of, you know, fish, you know, cod is, what shape, you know, we didn't know about it. So, you know, also this kind of thing done by only old people, kind of disappearing technique. You know, how it is hung and the things like that. So rainy day, we went to learn how to make a dried fish, dried cod. This is a cod. So each one, each young people try to clean a cod. Yeah, cord is quite, you know, three-dimensional body. Then the bone shape is triangle. It's not so easy to, you know, clean compared to other fish. And this is an ovary of a cod. Of course, there is a male and female, so female has ovary. You know, I mean, this is what we used to do. We all used to do, you know, cooking, you know, killing a chicken, and you know, but so you know, that's what we used to do. But even in Japan, we eat a fish, but we can just buy already cleaned fish at the supermarket. This is a testicle. This is a male cod. So we are making a dried fish, but the, you know, testicle ovary is a kind of delicacy part, so we keep it like this. So maybe this is a very ugly or odd things for you, but the, this food photography is quite interesting. If you know the taste, it's become a nice photography. If not, you know, just ugly, you know. But for me, this is quite a beautiful, you know, taste looking, you know, nice, you know, nice photograph. Yeah, put on a salt using a bamboo stick. Yeah, we hanging it. Again, we brought back to the museum. We're drying it at the museum. Actually, this is one thing I really want to show you today. This is something very special. I don't know if somebody know what it is. This is actually made of ovary of sea cucumber. This is a food. I mean, this is a very delicacy food, and but this is very special things. You know, they produce. Even Japanese people don't know about it, and only some in part of Japan, especially Noto people. Even some special people in Noto, they make this. So I especially wanted to learn how to make it because such a beautiful color and a nice shape. You know, maybe my first idea was I wanted to make a sculpture with it. But after learning this, I started to know this is really hard work because to make one piece like this, this size is like this shape, it's, you need like a 200 to 300 sea cucumber. So one piece is like the market price is like a 50 euro. So, I mean, it's not so easy to make a big sculpture with it. But anyway, I wanted to, so when we eat it, we eat it like this, for example, just grill it. So this is a sea cucumber. You know what is a sea cucumber, right? But maybe you don't know face of a sea cucumber. This is a face. Yeah, I mean, people say like a sea cucumber is like a sausage, but a sea cucumber has a face and the bottom and the back and the stomach. You know, this, I didn't know before, you know, touching it. So this is a face. So now you can be very proud, you know the face of sea cucumber. This is a place, you know, only old lady is doing it today. So they cut the stomach. So now you have to make sure where is the stomach of, you know, sea cucumber. They cut stomach with a knife. This is an ovary. But of course, you know, not all of them have an ovary. So they try to, how do you say, try to get like a four parts, like on the left side up, that is intestine, and underneath is ovary, and the right hand side up is that's a slow stomach part. And then right hand bottom, it's a lung. So we divide it in four parts. The eating intestine is quite popular in Japan. People love to eat intestine, you know, it's like a nice side dish for the sake and the things like that. So eating the intestine is not so special, but eating ovary is quite special. So I went to lung. This is interesting. It's quite beautiful, no? Yeah, this is just touching only a throat part. Yeah, this is interesting. Then this is a ovary and the testicle kind of mix. White part is a testicle, and the orange one is a ovary. So they mix. So he's a master of making this dried, you know, sea cucumber ovary. His name is Mr. Morikawa. He is a very special man. Yeah, he's even like a, he's like a fifth generation or something. Like his, you know, father, grandfather, grandfather used to do this all the time. Then he has his own special frame to hang them. Yeah, they just put on a string. Then they make, you know, like, but he says this is like making this thing. Actually, this is called kuchiko. So making kuchiko is like a fighting against earth because of gravity, you know, next day some, you know, falling down. So he said like making kuchiko is like a fighting against gravity, fighting against the earth. So they're drying it. Yeah, I tried to do it too, but next day most of the thing was really fallen. So I know now it's very difficult. Yeah, color is so beautiful, no? Don't you think? Like, you know, like live, you know. So I exhibited in this way in a museum. I mean, this is how they do it. You know, I didn't create anything. Just I tried to make the same kind of frame, and this is how he do it. And then actually this, you know, making kuchiko is only February and March, strangely, because ovary of sea cucumber become big only in February and March. So he is working only February and March. So I asked him, you know, what are you doing in the summer or other time? So he said he's making iron from soil, from earth. You know, he's making iron. So this is quite amazing. So. Also, I went to learn how to make iron from earth. So this is something, you know, like we are, I'm an artist, but, you know, if he said, like, I'm making iron, you know, like people say I'm making a table, but nobody make wood itself, right? But he's making iron, so I'm completely amazed about it. So we went to learn how to make iron, too, from soil. Beautiful, it's very beautiful. Like they say, like, oh, we have to bake the soil. You know, like it's very poetic, you know, baking a soil, baking a earth. Yeah, it's kind of long story, so maybe I'm going to stop. But I want to show you some, you know, only 2 minutes video footage for the end, because I think it's very interesting because it's like a kind of a modern way to do traditional things. So can we show the video? Also, this is dried fish. Maybe this is, you know. Yeah, for me it's interesting that this kind of traditional dried fish making is kind of updating in this way. And then also this is, you know, I want to show to Marcel Duchamp, you know, something, you know, close to, you know, glass drawing things. Yeah, also like when we talk about Johan, because you are always dealing about something disappearing, but you know, because it's beautiful and yeah, tastes good. It tastes good and beautiful things disappearing. That's why, you know, I want to keep them. Now this thing is very popular, like maybe some people started to make it, then others try to make something similar, kind of bricolage, you know, self-made machine to drying dry fish. Okay, thank you so much.